Hello and welcome to Slastar Racing. In today's video, I will show you a guide how to use R-Factor 2 Broadcaster. I know it has been a headache for many people to understand how it works, what to do. In this video, I will definitely try my best to show you guys how to use it and exactly what you need to do to get your own logos or sponsored logos on your standings relatives that is will be shown within the game. So, are you ready? Let's head in to the video. Alright, now you're on the website. I will give this link in the description below. This link that you see on the top here, and I will link this as well, because you need this one here in order to get to this section here, and we will get to that section soon enough. And you also need this if you're gonna use this for the broadcast on your OBS, XSplit, Gamecaster, or whatever browser source you're gonna use this on. And you also gonna need to download this. Link will be again in the link in the description below. So first, I will add the link on this first, and this second, and this third on the links. So first of all, I want you to download this default zip file. And that's what you're gonna do. Download that zip file, as I already done it now, as you can see. Once you have done that, you can just click on this one. So once you've done that, we'll get into the next section. Alright. Now, we are on this section here that we have downloaded it, so the next thing I want you to do is to click on the downloaded file you're done. Click on the default one. Bring it on your desktop. As you can see, I have my desktop here, but it says everything in my language, Norwegian. So, I'll just say desktop here for you guys, because that is the word you will understand. So, now I have the default map in here. As for now, I am currently using Windows 11. So, what I want you to do now is to right click on it. And the next thing you're going to do, just click in the very bottom of this one here to choose more alternatives or more options, whatever it is translated for. Click on that on Windows 11, and now you also got in this to Windows 10, which will be popping up for you. So give a new name for your folder and call it for over Lays with an S at the end. And once you've done that, then you drag it in to your R-Factor 2 where you installed your R-Factor 2. For me, it is this PC games on D section, program files 86. Steam, Steam Apps, Common, R-Factor 2. It depends where you installed your Steam, of course, and of course where you have installed your R-Factor 2. So once you have found your R-Factor 2 folder, the next I want you to do is to drag your overlays in to this R-Factor 2 map over here. And once you have done that, the next you have to do is to double click, and you're gonna right click again, and you're gonna make a new folder. Once you have created a new folder, call it whatever you want. For example, racing, for example. And that is what you should call it, or probably Formula One, or whatever you want to call your folder inside. Once you have done that, for me now, it is Formula One. And that is where you see the images. You double click on that, you see I already put my images in there. So just pick and choose whatever images you want inside the images position to override these R-Factor 2 Studio 397 logos. And foremost of all, you don't need to resize your images to match this. You don't have to. So once you have done this, please make sure you have, for example, your image name that you have, not like 5,000 numbers. That will be kind of out of a mess. All right. Once you have gone through this, now we're gonna go to the other section. Now that you are still in your R-Factor 2 folder and probably still in the overlays, now go back to R-Factor 2, just click on the R-Factor 2 on the top. The next you gotta do is go to User Data, Player, and the next you gotta do, if you're gonna have your images to work properly, you need to create your own overlays slash, or yeah, I will copy this in the link in the description below. So copy paste it. So first of all, you need to create a new text file, for example. Which in Norwegian for me is notice block, so it just make sure you have a text file open. And the next thing you gotta do is to copy this here. I will put this as well in the description below. And this is my folder name that I have called. For example, racing or Formula One. You probably need to do this differently if you create more folders. So that is what you need to do. So for now, I made a new folder, which I called for racing. I don't know if this is gonna work. I don't know. But I gotta try. So racing with store R, big letter R. So once we have done this, you hit file, save as, and you call it for overlays, and config.js on. That will be your file where you will save it in the user data and player inside the R-Factor 2 folder. So R factor 2, user data, player, and save this here, and you should be good to go once we hit save. Once you have done all of that, so the next will be for the images in the config.json file. Alright, now we are on my Formula 1 folder that I created inside the overlays. So the next thing you gotta do, click config.json file, double click on it, and you will get this fair files here up. What you gotta do next is to scroll all the way down until you see the left add, and right cycling ads, and so forth of this page here. So for me though, as you already have seen of my images, I actually have those in here. It has the logo 3 and the test image here as well, as I already have put it in the images file to this section. You have to put them in the image or else it won't work. So once you have opened this config.json file, you name your image that you want to show. You just need to remove, for example, my test there. You call it a different name for another logo, for example. Type your image name that you want to be shown in, and you need to keep this PNG file here with this dot. Just remove as much with that. Alright, so once you've done that, you are basically good to go, almost. And this is kind of color codes that you can change for whatever you want to change it to. I haven't dived much into those different things. I don't have much of information of the video slide and towers of these things, what this does, but you can change your commentator names. For example, me as Slostad here, for example, and my, for example, my cat, for a example, like Achilles. And that will be the commentator's name that will be shown in the directors of who is broadcasting and the commentators that is commentating the races while others is having fun driving. So once you've done that, you hit save as, no, just hit save, control S. And once you've done that, then you are good to go. So the next will be back here. Alright, now we are back on here, and as you can already see, so that you're gonna need to do now is to open the local host, for example. So you get this thing here up, but you need to launch a game before you open this up though, or else it won't work. So you can see my RFactor 2 is up and everything here is on here working for me. It only works on replays or only to show directly on screen. That's the only way it works, unless you do it as a browser source, but we'll get to that in a moment. So for example, you have the countdown and it pops up like this. As you can see, I haven't changed the Studio 397 there, but this one here has changed. So if I go back, you can, for example, go to the intro and you can see my logos is appearing up on this section here. You can go to the event, for example, and you see the Automaster logo, for example, here. You have the circuit name that you need to name every time you are on track, that you need to type in yourself in the JSON file. So you need to do that every time you go for a different track and race, which is kind of tiring. So once you have done all of this, you can show your schedule for when you're next live. Again, you see my logos, round one, round two. Still, you need to change this every time you do a different race, and so forth. So that is the only way this will work. You have, like, for example, mark replay events. So if something happening, you can mark that section and it will show up as a replay. And you hit that replay event there, and this will appear up for a replay. And you see that is how it shows up in a replay. That somebody had a bug while powering up. And you can remove that replay afterwards. And you have the session result that you can show. And it will appear like this. And you have mid-race results that also will pop up. That will show the drivers' names and everyone else that is inside here and competing. Session standings. It will show who is on the top lead, who does the best on the points, and so forth. Depends on the drivers itself. So yeah. But again, you need to probably customize these teams as well in the JSON file. So yeah, I'll show you this later on. You have the driver box, which is this one below here, to leader, to next, and qualifying. So this is just for the qualifying, and it will kind of look like this, that you can see the time and the splits between, I think it is. And you have one versus one battle. So you can see the gap to your opponent and so forth. And this is only for the broadcasting, of course, if when you do broadcasting, talking and stuff like this, you need to have this browser source open every time if you want it to work properly. Once you are doing this, you need exactly a double screen. One you can just control and go back and forth with, and control this while the race is on, or you have to make a double thing there. Other people need to that someone is streaming it. You can probably stream that on your PC, and other one is controlling the scenes for you. You can do it that way as well, but you have to do that through the IP addresses. So you can just go through around here, experiment, but as first of all, yours is probably on default here. If it's on default and you see Formula One here, for example, whatever you call it, you click on this one and turn click on Formula One. Click refresh overlays. And you'll basically get your overlay to work. Like so. And that is what you will get. And that will be the live feed after everything is done. Of course, once you hit the replay, you always, if you want to go back to the live feed itself, you need to go to live feed after you have done the replay. Or else you will be stuck in the replay section all the time. All right. I hope I have covered up enough for this one. I hope you also learned a lot of it. And let's get to the other sections. All right, here I will cover up schedule, standings, and vehicle info overrides. But I still don't know how this is working, but because I haven't tested this one out, but these two is I know how works kind of. You remember that I showed you guys the schedule of the race? You can put the date of when of the year it starts and the month you want it to begin again. So you viewers can know when the race is, and you have the track location. You need to type this in all by yourself. You can just copy paste this if you want more races than four. Just copy paste and do so all the time until you are satisfied of how many races you want to do. But in order to do all of this here, you actually need to put the location in manually every time. But be warned, this might also reset itself during live streaming while the race is ongoing. That actually might happen. That was also happened in the config.json as well when it comes to the commentators. And for the standings, you can choose the points. But I think you need manually to add these points in yourself. I don't know. But you also need to change the car class so it's correctly. And the car ID, I'm not sure what that kind of is. I've never been through this, so I'm the wrong person to ask for that, but yeah. And you have this as the Martin Vintage vehicle name, and you have the A team, driver A, car number, for example. This is just, I think this is just covering up some things I really don't know. But you can try to check it out yourself and see if you can learn something. And if you learn something about this, make a video about it. It is very good content. People is actually searching for this. because everyone doesn't understand this. I am don't understand all of it myself. And for the vehicle, this is, for example, names you want to be used on your, for example, your own league races, for example. I don't know how this is actually working, but I don't think you actually need this anymore, because if people have their correct names, then you should basically be good. But I think this is just only for the team names, I don't know. So I just look away from this because, yeah. It's out of my league of understanding. I'm just happy that I understood the overlays, the broadcasting itself. So that is actually basically everything you need to do to make everything to work, just to get your logo and this to pop up. That's basically everything you need to do. And that's it, guys. I hope this video was really helpful for you. And if you still have questions, please let me know in the comments below. And hit the like and join me on Discord, the link in the description below. Twitter, you can reach out to me wherever in Discord or Twitter if you want and still need help. In Discord, we can do videos like chat if you need assist, and I can take off my, a few of my time just to help you out and see if we get it right for you. All right. Thank you all, everyone, for watching, and until the next video, I'll see you on the next one. All right, guys. Take care.